Windows Server Core. Windows Server Core compatibility. Is it administrator's daydream or is it troubleshooting nightmare? While Windows Server Core is secure, fast, and reliable, it lacks a little bit of compatibility as well. It's not as compatible with other applications that already exist in the software as a desktop experience version. When you have a Windows with graphical user interface, you can easily install all your line of business applications and run them. But with Windows Server Core, it might lack the compatibility with many of the existing applications. So, how do we overcome these issues? Microsoft has listened and responded to this issue. Windows application compatibility and feature on demand can significantly increase the compatibility version of Windows Server Core. It is an optional add-on package that you can add to your Windows Server Core to significantly increase the compatibility and also add a lot of Microsoft Management or MMC consoles to your Windows Server Core for troubleshooting purposes. Windows Application Compatibility Feature on Demand is an optional package which you can get online or get it through an installation version of Windows and add it to your Server Core. My name is Ali. And in this short video, I'm going to show you how to download and install Windows Application Compatibility Feature on Demand on Windows Server Core. If you need to know how to install Windows Server Core or do the post configuration, watch the video on top of your screen and join me back again. Let's start. Before starting the process, please note you can only install this package on Windows Server Core. Do not try to install it on servers with desktop experience. For Windows Server 2022, ensure that you have installed the CU Update 2022-01 with the KB number KB5009608 or later. To verify, check your OS build number and it should be greater than 20348.502. If your server has access to internet, you can simply run the command and add the package online. From your Windows Server Core command prompt, type in PowerShell to open PowerShell and run add-windows capability command. Type add-windows capability-online-name server core.app compatibility for --0.0.1.0. This will download the package from Microsoft Update website and install it on your server core. Server needs to be restarted after installation is finished. If your server does not have access to the internet, you can download and add the package manually. You will need to download Windows Server language and optional features, and then add the package manually. From your favorite search engine, search for Windows Server 2022 evaluation. From the list, select the link from Microsoft website and click the download ISO. I've also included the link in the description for your quick access. Once you have completed the download, save the file into a shared folder that can be accessed through the network. You will need to access this file from your server core. Step 1. On your server core, you will need to create a map drive that points to the shared folder that contains the downloaded ISO file. This will allow your server core to access the shared location. By the way, in the description below, you can find all the commands used in this tutorial. First, create a variable to get the credentials, and we will use that variable in the future commands. Next, create a new map drive by using the new-psdrive command line. Type in new-psdrive-name, I'm calling it FOD share-psprovider-filesystem-root, and then enter the address of the shared location. Make sure to put your address in quotes. And lastly, -credentials and the variable which we created earlier. On step 2,
we need to copy the ISO file from the shared location to your local core server. For this, you need to create two variables, one that points to the local folder on your server core. I'm using ISO folder, and then another variable that points to the ISO file name. In this example, I have renamed my ISO file to FOD to make the commands shorter. Now copy the file by using new-item and copy-item PowerShell commands. Create a placeholder for the file by typing new-item-itemtype directory-path and the variable for ISO folder. Then copy the file by running copy-item-path folder share / folder ISO file name, which is the variable we created earlier, - destination and the destination folder. Depending on your computer and network speed, this step might take a few minutes. In this step, computer is transferring the file from your shared location to your local server core. After the copy is completed, mount the ISO file and get the drive letter. Mount the ISO by using the mount-disk-image PowerShell command. To get the drive letter, create a new variable and use the get-volume commandlet. As the final step, you can add the package by running Windows capability commandlet. Type add-windows-capability-online-name servercore.appcompatibility4.0.0.1.0-source. Then we will use the address of our source file. This will add the language and optional features to your Windows server core. You will need to restart the server, and then you can start testing the installation. After the package is added, you can test the installation by running some of the consoles. For example, you can run mmc by typing mmc in the command prompt. This will open an empty Microsoft Management Console, which allows you to add your desired snap-ins. You can also check server performance metrics by typing perfmon and checking the performance monitor console, or type resmon to open the resource monitor. You can also type in devmgmt.msc to open the device manager console and see the details of every hardware that is installed on your server. The most fun to use console has to be the file explorer. Type explorer and hit enter and enjoy working with the file explorer on your server core. If you need to work with PowerShell scripts and need the ISE, just type in PowerShell_ISE to open up the tool and start editing your scripts in PowerShell ISE. You can even work with the disks in Disk Management Console by typing diskmgmt.msc. This will open our traditional Disk Management Console. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to the channel for more videos like this. Make sure to hit the bell icon to be notified when the new content is released. Also, leave a comment in the comment section down below and let me know what other subjects would you like to learn. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you on the next video.